In this video, I have this funny language and I show you how to prove with the pumping lemma that this language is not regular. First, we have a look at what words this language contains. So it says that the strings contains a's and the amount of a's is n to the power of 2. So that means if n is 1, 1 to the power of 2 is 1, so the first word will be a, then 2 to the power of 2 will be 4, so the next word will consist of 4 a's, and because the next word already takes very long to write down, I can make it shorter. I can say my first word consists of 1 a's, the next word consists of 4 a's, so it's just a short form for the long words. Then the next word will be 3 to the power of 2 will be 9. The next word will be a to the power of 16 and so on and so on. And I think you already see the pattern. So they are always square numbers. So they are the next word is the difference between the words is increasing. So if you are looking at the words of a usual regular language, then what you see, if you order all the words by their length, then there's always the same distance between the words. So maybe the next word is one letter longer than the previous one, or every word is three letters longer than the previous one. Or, of course, you can have words of the same length, but there's a linear growth in it. Now, if you are looking at this language, then you, at the length of the words from this language, then you have an exponential growth. So, there's no constant growth, but the growth is increasing. So if you remember the definition of multi-context sensitive languages, which are more expressive than context-free languages, they include all languages that have a constant growth. So that means that this language, because it has an exponential growth and not a linear one, that means it cannot be regular, it cannot be context-free, and it cannot be multi-context sensitive. Now, if I would not need to use the pumping lemma, I could maybe use the definition. But now let's start with the pumping lemma. So as always, I make my assumption that L is regular. And as always, I will lead this to a contradiction. Now, if you remember, the pumping lemma says that there's a constant capital N, and the pumping lemma applies to all words longer as those n. And now I want to generate a word that's longer than n. So, and this word is a to the power of those capital N. So that's my constant from the pumping lemma. I just imply it as a variable here. So I know that this word must be longer than n. Now let's have a look at the previous word, let's call it x minus 1, and this one would be a to the power of n minus 1 squared, and if I multiply this out, it will be a to the power of 2n, it will be, of course, a to the power of n squared minus 2n plus 1. So that means if you look at the distance between those words, between my x minus 1 and my x, the distance is I would need, when I want to turn this word into that one, I would need to add 2n a's, and I would need to subtract 1 to get the next word. Now, if I look at the next word after that, so let's call it x plus 1 or something, then it will have the length of a to the power of n plus 1 squared, and if I multiply this out, it will be a to the power of n squared plus 2n plus 1. And if you look now at the distance between these two words, I would need to add 2n plus 1 letters to this word. So, now the when I go to the formal stuff, I need a separation of x into u, v, w, and I put some a's into the v, so that's my pumpable part. But the pumping lemma also says that u and v together are smaller than my n. Now that means I can put at most n letters into v, but when I put n letters into v and I pump it one time, then my next word would be a n to the power of 2 plus n, and that's not enough to reach the next word. So the pumping lemma says that I have to find a separation so that I can put in I need to find a separation so that when I pump v to any amount, then the word must be in the language. So here you see one problem. When I now put the most amount of n's into v, I will reach something in between, but it's not enough to reach the next word. So it's not possible to find a separation that fulfills these conditions. And there's even another problem. Now, So if I could put in as many letters as I wanted into V, so for example, but if I make the other point clear, if I would say V contains a to the power of n letters, then U, V, W would give me the word a to the power of n squared plus n, so that is not in the language. So if I were allowed to put as many letters as I wanted into V, so which I'm not allowed, so what, just for to make this point clear, if I could say, for example, it should be the same amount so that I will get exactly to the same word, so V will be 2n plus 1, then if I would now double those V, I would come to the next word, but when I now pump it down and say I want to have zeros of those V, so I'm pumping down instead, then I would have a to the power of n squared minus 2n minus 1. So that is not the same as this one. So it doesn't matter how many a's I put into v. One point is I'm not allowed to put as many a's into v as I would need. And the other point is if I were allowed to, then I would either miss the previous word or I would miss the next one. So we have the contradiction, and that means L cannot be, L is not regular.